morning, everyone. Welcome to the show. I'm Teresa Dufour.
And I'm Ryan Christopher. It's 9 o'clock. Thank you so much for joining us here on this Wednesday morning, hump day, and we have a great show today, as we do every day.
We do. How was your ride into work today?
It was a little rough today. I hit my first animal.
And, well,
It kind of hit me. I was on 91.
It hit you.
Yeah. Well, it flew by me. Yeah. A bird clipped my car, and it was just out of nowhere, and I felt so bad. I almost, like, started crying. I almost caused an accident on 91. I thought I would end up in one of your traffic reports.
Such a heart-wrenching.
I just feel very bad. I was like very depressed all morning. And
what are you gonna do?
I don't know. Not much of it.
Is it on your car still? I mean, I guess I don't need the details, but
let's just say I had to roll down my window to put my little key card in to get into work, and
It
was a sad moment.
Probably heard a thump too, right?
Yeah, like, yeah.
Didn't know what was going on.
I'm getting a little emotional.
Can we get past this?
Yeah, please.
All right, so what's brewing? Here's what's happening in your kids' classroom. So there's now an app on the market that makes finding friends in the school cafeteria a piece of cake.
Oh, I see what you did there. It's called Sit With Us, and it helps students who have a little difficulty finding the right place to sit locate a welcoming group in the lunchroom. It's very nice, and the app allows students to designate themselves as quote unquote ambassadors, thereby inviting others to join them. They can post a quote-unquote open lunch, or they can signal to anybody seeking company that, hey, come on over, you are invited.
I think that's a nice idea, but I mean, do we need an app for that? Can't little kids just say, come sit with us?
I don't know.
Do they have phones in school? Which was my other thought.
I mean, I think they definitely should. My freshman year of high school, I sat by myself like a majority of the year, I think.
No,
I know.
You didn't.
Well, I was the new kid and nobody really knew me, so they were like, who's that weird, blanky, bizarre kid over there? We don't want to sit with him.
I'm shocked nobody sat with you.
But if I had an app for that, I would.
You would have used it?
Maybe use it. I mean, it might be a little embarrassing, you know, knowing that you're on the app, but I think kids just need to be a little more forward.
Come
and
sit with,
welcoming.
Just invite the kid next,
yes.
Right?
Anybody here in the studio, come sit on the couch.
We have plenty of room here.
Later on in the show, they'll be on it.
How did you make friends eventually? They found out your charming personality?
I got a TV show and then eventually.
Now everyone likes you.
Yeah. That's what it is.
All right, so this might be a scary thought for some folks. Scientists say that men might someday be able to conceive babies. That is a ridiculous picture.
This photo, what is going on?
They figured out a way to use skin cells instead of eggs to make embryos. Come on. But the research is still at an early stage, and there are a lot of obstacles to overcome.
Don't researchers have anything better to do than to try to?
Why are we messing with
nature
here?
With real life. And my question is, where does it come out? Where does?
Maybe you'd have a C-section. I don't really know.
Let's hope. Because that would be quite the experience.
Stupid. But, I don't even know why we're talking about this. This is a really dumb conversation.
But I do think, Teresa, that even moreover the physical aspect, I don't think men could mentally sustain having a child. I don't think that we can do it mentally.
Is it like the pain, or are you just the self-discipline, or what is it?
All of the above. Women are such strong beings, you know? I mean, you guys are built for childbirth. Like, where would the baby protrude from? I don't understand.
I don't know. I think you expand, right?
I don't think
get beer guts.
Yeah, well, that's a good point. Maybe replace it with the beer there.
I don't think that'll ever happen in our lifetime,
please,
Rye.
Please, go research something else. Well, regardless of your gender, this couple, they're not having any trouble in the kid department. They've just had their 13th child. It's a married couple from Northeast Brazil. And get it, they have all boys.
Oh,
ranging
my gosh.
From...
They keep trying to have a girl. That is crazy. They have a newborn all the way to an 18-year-old. Now, the couple once vowed to keep trying for that girl until 2 years ago when they had yet another boy, and they said they were done. Well, they had a newborn 2 years ago. That's probably...
Yeah, they're doing their thing, but it's funny because you know how some people, they name like all the same letter?
Like the Kardashians?
Yes, just like that. Well, this family, they've named them all R's after professional soccer players.
Are you going to read them all?
I'm going to try to speed reading. Robson, Riemann, Raul, Rubin, Rivaldo, Ron, Ramon, Rincon, Riquelme, Ramirez, Ralson, Rafael, and Ronaldo.
You tried.
They
could have their own soccer team.
They are.
Yeah. Right?
You're onto something.
Wow.
Make some money off those kids.
That's so interesting. That's the man's fault that they're all boys.
Is it?
It is.
Is that what they say?
Yeah, blame dad on that one.
Well, okay.
All right, so you're a cat fan. Where's your cat mug? I love my cat.
I'm washing it upstairs.
I
only bring it out once a week, I think. But this is pretty cute because in the London subway station, it's now being invaded by kitty cats. So there
you
used to be
so happy, Ryan.
This would be nice. You know, they should get one here on Metro North or something as part of a crowdfunded campaign. Advertisements are being replaced with these pictures of kitties. There's a guy taking a selfie there. The campaign started Monday.
Do they need homes? Like, are these cats that need to be adopted?
Yes, they are cats that do need to be adopted.
It.
So they've raised $26,000 so far to make 68 ads disappear.
Oh, people weren't crazy about them.
about the advertisements that were there. So they replaced them with the cat picture. So you know how here in the hallways at WTNH, we have all of our headshots in the hallway. So take a look. We have a picture. So I decided to do a little redecorating just to spruce things up a hair. Let's take a look. So there it is.
You just put Hunter over our picture?
Yeah, right? I mean, why not? I think it's cute, and maybe we could raise some money for it.
That's great. Maybe. That's really funny. We'll see if it's there at the end of the show.
Yeah. No. Okay. Apparently, they took both of our pictures down now. So, anywho.
You are getting in the fall season with your Cruising Connecticut stories.
Fall spirit. Yeah. We found pumpkin picking, apple picking already. So now we're doing apple cider donuts, and we checked out some of the spots here in Connecticut that you guys like best, and we headed on over to Beardsley Cider Mill and Orchard over in Shelton.
Our family has been on this farm since 1849. In 1973, a school bus lost its brakes, crashed into our dairy barn, and burned it to the ground. So we had no more cider press. That was my grandfather's. In 1999, my father and I opened this cider mill.
You think of cider and also apple cider donuts.
Cider donuts.
Show us how to make today.
Absolutely. What we do, it's a little different than most places, is we finish them in this conveyor oven, and that makes the outside just a little bit crunchy.
Crunchy.
And our customers tell us that's what makes them better than most places. Instead of water when they make the dough, it's made with cider, and it also has pureed apples in there. So it's not just a cinnamon and sugar donut. It's an actual apple cider donut. I do three at a time across the row. You don't want to touch them. And when they come out the other side.
If you're ever having a bad day, do you ever just sneak in here and have a few donuts?
It's my father around. I do occasionally do that, yes. They're going to be nice and hot and ready to accept the cinnamon and sugar. See?
All right, then. Oh,
nice and hot. Make sure you get a good coating on there. Hot cider donuts.
You've done well, my man.
We did all right.
Not too shabby.
Can you taste the apple flavor in there?
Yeah, let's do
That's
seven more part. Takes just to be sure. Do you mind?
Not at all.
So try one for yourself there.
Can
Teresa.
I have one of
yeah,
these?
Have
There's a couple
one, two,
left.
Three.
Kevin had like 10 of them
Yes,
this morning.
Kevin had quite the appetite this morning.
Mm.
Good?
Yeah, I wish I had some cider, though.
Look, conveniently so. Benny,
oh
thank
gosh,
you very much.
Oh, my gosh, Benny Brunson, thanks for the cider.
I will pour this for you, Teresa. Thank you, Mr. Brunson. It's the ultimate event here, Win It Wednesday. For anybody who loves being out on the water, it's Progressive's Norwalk Boat Show. It's happening at the Norwalk Cove Marina, September 22nd to the 25th.
And you can win tickets. All you have to do is go to the WTNH.com contest page. And later on, we're going to tell you about the other contest, which is pretty intense. We're going to have all those details.